Hello and you're watching TV9 News and I'm your host Deepak. Now as India continues to battle the raging pandemic, oxygen concentrators and cylinders are high in demand. While hospitals are trying to maintain a continuous supply of the life-saving gas, those in home isolation might also need concentrated oxygen to fight the infection. So, in this video, I will get all the answers to your questions like how it works, when you should buy an oxygen concentrator, the prices, best models, and also more details. So, first, let's understand what an oxygen concentrator is. Let me tell you this first. The air that we breathe, not everything is oxygen. Only 21% of the air that we inhale in our body is oxygen. The rest is nitrogen and other gases. And this 21% of oxygen concentration is enough for humans to breathe properly. So what the oxygen concentrator does is it promises endless supply of the life-saving gas. Now, how does it work? Well, it sucks air from the environment, removes the unwanted gases, and blows the concentrated oxygen or pure oxygen through a pipe so that the patients can breathe easily. And Dr. Sitesh Roy, who's a clinical immunologist and an allergist, will tell us more about oxygen concentrators.
An oxygen concentrator is a medical device that basically takes normal ambient surrounding air that's around us, which has 21% oxygen and 78% nitrogen, and extracts the oxygen out of it while releasing the nitrogen back into the atmosphere. And by doing so, it is able to give a 24/7 constant supply of oxygen to an individual who needs it. This is basically a process in which we are extracting O2 out of our environment and using it for medical reasons. In this process, the oxygen is also pressurized to some extent to be given to an individual, but not to a very high pressure level. And also the rates of flow can only be between 5 liters or 10 liters per minute, whereas a sick individual might need up to 30 or 40 liters per minute speeds of oxygen when they are having difficulty breathing.
Now, speaking about oxygen concentrators, there are two types of this device. One is the home oxygen concentrators. The second one is the portable oxygen concentrators. Now, speaking of home oxygen concentrators, as the name suggests, home oxygen concentrators are the ones that can be used at home. These types of oxygen concentrators work on electricity. They require power from your wall socket for them to function. And home oxygen concentrators can provide a significantly higher amount of oxygen compared to portable oxygen concentrators. Now, speaking of portable oxygen concentrators, they are the ones that are portable, which means they can be carried around easily. And these types of concentrators don't need continuous supply of power from a wall socket for them to work because they have an inbuilt battery. And once it is fully charged, portable oxygen concentrators can provide oxygen for 5 to 10 hours straight. Now, the next important question is, when should you get an oxygen concentrator? Dr. Roy, could you please tell our viewers about when a person should get an oxygen concentrator?
So, Deepak, typically oxygen concentrators have been used for people with chronic pulmonary diseases like chronic obstructive pulmonary disease called COPD, interstitial lung disease, pulmonary fibrosis, bronchiectasis, and other chronic lung diseases. They are the people who eventually require oxygen on an off and on basis throughout the day or sometimes the entire day. But lately in COVID-19, because there has been a shortage of oxygen supply, people have been buying oxygen concentrators. Typically, we would recommend only those who are being discharged from the hospital and have had a severe COVID-19 course. And at the end of their hospital stay, while the infection is gone, their need for oxygen has not ended. Those would be the people who would most benefit from having oxygen concentrators in their home. For others to keep oxygen concentrators, there would need to be extraneous situations in which they would benefit from having an oxygen supply should someone in their neighborhood or family become sick and require oxygen emergently.
So if you are someone who is affected by COVID-19 and your oxygen level is hovering between 90% and 94%, you can get yourself an oxygen concentrator and breathe with its help. But this should get you through the situation. And if it falls beyond 90%, then you definitely need to get hospitalized. But then before we move forward, there is one more important clarification. Oxygen concentrators and oxygen cylinders aren't the same. So what's the difference between the two then? Well, Dr. Roy will tell us more about the differences between oxygen concentrators and an oxygen cylinder.
An oxygen cylinder has a fixed quantity of oxygen in it, whether it's 10 liters, 20 liters, 50 liters, 100 liters, 200 liters, there are many sizes, and this oxygen is pressurized oxygen, which typically is somewhere between 1500 to 2000 psi. And that same pressurized oxygen is released at a pressure of about 50 psi to the individual who is taking it either through nasal prongs, nasal cannula, or through a face mask. The issue with oxygen cylinders is that they do run out, they get over, and they have to be refilled or replaced, and hence it becomes a cumbersome process sometimes. An oxygen concentrator, on the other hand, because it's extracting oxygen from our environment, can do so on a continuous basis 24/7 and can have several days even of functioning before it may require any kind of breaks, which are generally not needed because these devices are designed for giving a continuous oxygen supply. So that is the key difference between the pressurized oxygen cylinders versus an oxygen concentrator.
So now if you need an oxygen concentrator, where do you buy it from? Well, the best ones in the market are the oxygen concentrators manufactured by brands like Philips, BPL, and also Acer Biomedicals. So we suggest that you directly reach out to the oxygen concentrator company through their website, get a number for the dealer in your particular area, and buy an oxygen concentrator from them directly. If you buy it from a third party, then they will most probably charge you up to twice the amount as the MRP of the oxygen concentrator. Also, I will leave the links of the website from where you can buy oxygen concentrators in the description below. And share this video if you've liked the content, and do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to TV9 News on various social media platforms. Many thanks for watching.